I'm in the middle of doing two projects, and I'll probably have the answer by the time you see this video, but I have the TV sitting on a chair here. It's the bigger TV of the two. And whenever I'm trying to program it, it's saying that it already has my email address on another television or something like that. But I'm trying to figure out why this thing doesn't know that a person can have more than one television. So I gave up on that for now because I don't feel like dealing with it. Plus, it's not urgent. And this is what I've been working on. This is a shoe rack. I got it off of Amazon, and I'm just going to show you what it's supposed to be looking like. Well, this is what it's supposed to be looking like. Just a simple fabric and some poles. And it's supposed to hold all these shoes. At least two pair per shelf. It says 10 tier tall shoe rack, 20 to 25 pairs of shoes. And I feel like this will accommodate all of my shoes, and that's what I want. But I also don't want the shoes down on the floor necessarily, where I have to ruffle through them or under the bed. I want to put the shoes out for one thing. It's because I'm tired of not realizing what shoes I have when I'm trying to pick an outfit and shoes getting forgotten about. So this way I feel like I will have the opportunity to see the shoes as well as I see my outfits. I am a person that will never have a closet where the door is all the way shut. I need to like be able to just peer into the closet and see what I have rather than just opening up the closet and ruffling through. I just like to gaze in there and just kind of see what I have and then decide what I want to wear. So for the shoe rack, it's going to go somewhere in the room. I'm not sure which wall yet because I'm still tweaking out the place. Like it's annoying because it just comes with these pieces. It reminds you of IKEA stuff. Well, not really. It's just I'm tired of putting stuff together. And especially when it has these poles and these corners and these things right here. I'm just so tired of that. I just wish it would just be mostly put together. And I basically have to snap three pieces together and then I got my perfect height. So off screen, I assembled all of the parts here you see, and then I'll show you further. I have three more to put on. Believe it or not, I didn't really want to do this, build this, but I'm glad I did. Clearly you see it's taller than me. And depending on the shoes, I guess, you can put two to three pair up here, up on each shelf. I never saw a shoe shelf like this, but the way it was displayed, it just made it look really different. And the fact that it exposes all of my shoes, that part I like a lot. I can't find the holes because it's all too tall for me now. And for reference, here's my wall heater, right? So you know how tall a wall heater is. And look at that. Wall heater. So I'm excited to put shoes on here. Yes. I think I'm supposed to be securing it or doing something to have some hooks up here where you can hook bags on it or whatever. But I just think this is just so neat by itself. I'm so glad I got it. Good morning. I'm going to be just doing stuff around the apartment. And I just thought I'd bring you along. So for the first thing I want to do is I finished assembling my, it came with these little hooks to hook on, I guess to hook bags on or whatever. I'm not really sure how I'm going to use that. So I'm going to go figure out, I'm going to go set this up. I put it together last night, and I'm going to put it in the room. The room is a bit of a mess because I've been away. Because I sleep on the couch, obviously the bedroom becomes like storage kind of situation. It turns into a catch-all. Like I said, I'm just waking up. I slept on the couch. And then first thing I did was light this candle this morning. It's from Walmart. And it's like such a subtle scent. As soon as I warm up, I'm going to open up the windows and let some air in. But I made avocado toast this morning. The way I made it is the first time I ever made it this way. It was so good. So I might show you like tomorrow morning if I continue to film how I make that. I already had two avocado toast, so I can't make another one just to show you. And then I'm just drinking coffee. A friend of mine gave me two Keurig cups of caramel and some other flavors. And I don't care for it, but you know, I might put it in the freezer and finish it off as iced coffee.
In the meantime, I'm going to show you the room because that's the part that I was going to bring you along with.
That's what we're going to work on today. And I don't still have like proper lighting in this place. On the bed, we're going to start with, well, just the bed has stuff on it because it's like clothes I wore this week, I guess you can say. Far as the rest of the room, the room's not like finished. The apartment's not finished for that matter. What I had to do to help me mentally just kind of get over the clutter, I had to kind of put combinations of things that are alike and then just line it up against the wall. And so against the wall here is just like my stationery, because you know I have a lot of stationery, and office supplies and tech stuff and electronic stuff, fan, whatever, two fans, and then my cabinet from IKEA. This is dirty clothes right here that I'm gonna go wash, but a great deal of that's hand wash. This bag I decided to put some DVDs in it and journals, but that's just to kind of put groups together. Here is my shoes. They have been in this tub for quite a while, and I'm going to go ahead and set that up, and that's the point of this video today. And I don't know if I told you about the nightstands. The clear nightstand is from Amazon. Just pushed them together. It's two of them. And then I got these little drawers from Target. It came in a three set for like $15. So I'm using one for a file cabinet. I'll show you that shortly. And then these two I just put under here for like, you know, just like a drawer. This is my jewelry box. And then I just set stuff on it because the same thing, just trying to get stuff out of the way. And so let's gonna clear this off because I feel like I might need to move this over some. I'm pretty sure that I'm pretty sure it'll fit in this corner here. This is where I want the shoe rack, so I'm going to leave that there. As it turns out, I don't really like these blackout curtains. I mean, I like it for the blackout ability, but I don't like the way they look or the way they feel. It's too thick and chunky light. I'm going to go ahead and get the rack and bring it in here. As reference, this is how tall it is. At the three-piece set that I got from Target for $15, this is what they came in, like in here. So I'm now using this for my file cabinet. And my file folders, they came from the, I forget where they came from. Should I keep it flushed or give a little room on the side? Center. So it's taller than me. And then we're just going to put some shoes on top of it just to see. Since I have some sneakers sitting out, we're going to go put them on top. So a good two pair of shoes fit, obviously, properly. This is just me putting them up, no rhyme or reason. Definitely gonna have to fudge it along because I have a ton of shoes where I think that I'm just gonna make it, let's see. I can squeeze other shoes in, you know what I mean? Like this. You can just squeeze these in here. It's nothing like being able to see what you have and stop yourself from buying the same thing over and over, because it's easy to do for me. Because I get out there and I have a type when it comes to shoes that I like, and I'll just continue to buy the same things over. I'm not sure. Let's see. Maybe I could put some boots up there because that's enough spot. I think I'm going to use that top shelf to put purses. Even though I have a system for my purses, I'll show you that in a second. And it's just by using a clip that I got from Dollar Tree. So I have one more roll to go, with the exception of places I can put shoes in between. This hook rack right here is what I got from Dollar Tree, and it has multiple hooks on it. So I hook bags on it. It may not be able to hold all of the bags. I think this is probably a little too heavy for the setup, but I will tweak that shortly. But and it doesn't look that nice and neat with these. This is my lunch bag my niece gave me. But you have my cute purses, the colorful ones, on the side there. I'm gonna have to keep that there because that's perfect to me. Got one last shelf. Gonna shimmy these in between here. Some clear flip-flops. Sneakers. So guys, that is a bit much. But then you figure, like I'm trying to explain to you. You have the shoes here. It's almost like you're walking in a closet with a bed in it. But you have your clothes where you can easily see, your pants up there, the shoes there, and then, let's see. So when I give the finished room tour, you'll be able to see everything and how it turns out. But here's the rest of the shoes that I have left. And it's just some boots, some flats. Oh, these can fit on there somewhere. I love these. Yeah. So these are the shoes that I have left that I have to kind of find a home for. Oh, one more shoes, tan shoes. They're like these blue ones. They're sitting on the bed because I was going to wear them when I went away. Where are they? It's right here. So they in turn need a home. My perfect use. The goal is to get three pair of shoes on each of these. My like seasonal stuff, like extremely, like I would never wear this spring and summer. So these can definitely be hidden away in the closet floor. fit 3 pair of shoes up in each of these spots. That's all I'm trying to say. These are going to go up here. Feel like if I can't make it fit, then it's time to say goodbye. To probably could say goodbye to at least a third of these, but we're going to see how we work this in before we start shedding, purging. I think it's gonna look too tacky if I put 3 pairs of shoes on. It don't have to be like all perfectly 2-2-2 all the way down. I think it'd be fine if I have 3 and them squeezed in somehow. So the point is, it's just a shoe rack to put the shoes and be able to see them and just, you know, see what you have at a glance. So that's what that's all we're doing in here. I wanted to take this little shelf here. And it's in the hallway, but I wanted to put books on it. It's a bookshelf. And I know that everything is like subject to change and temporary. Until I'm able to finish shedding things and finding real homes for stuff, I have to kind of tweak things as we go daily. Right now, I'm going to take a little break because filming and being hot is like, filming makes you hot. And so now I'm going to take a little water break. Somebody called me or text me. Guys, for the record, I grew up in California, so we didn't separate our clothes. But I lived in New England for 10 years, and you had no reason to keep your summer clothes out for the winter and vice versa. So I think with that in mind, I'm going to use this tub. Once I finish purging out the shoes, I think I'm going to use this tub for putting the winter shoes and some winter items in here, like really winterish. And then I'm just going to put it on the bottom of the floor of the closet because I do have all of this room down there. We have like maybe some sweaters that are really thick and some coats, not coats, but sweaters that are really thick, the shoes. And I know I need to keep the rain boots out because the rain boots, they, you know, it's subject to rain anytime. But for the most part, after purging some of the shoes, and then I'm going to use this as a winter storage bin. As it will help with the elimination of some of the shoes up here. Like literally, to me, all of these can be worn through, you know, the rest of the season. But I'm just going to have to purge, and then I'm going to go ahead and use that for that reason. It's some things going on in my head right now that has me to the point where I'm not as proactive in putting this place together. And I don't want to talk about what that is, but that's just kind of keeping me kind of like where I'm not moving as fast as I feel like I want to move, because I feel like I want to move a little faster sometimes. But it's a nice day out. Yesterday, I had them both on trying to program this one, and it said it wouldn't let me because it's asking for my email and stuff. So, yeah, this is the actual TV for the living room. That one's for the bedroom. I'm going to go ahead and set this up, and then we'll declutter this stuff and decorate because that's what I wanted to do today. Everything on here is just there to be out of a box and in a category of alike. I realize my theme for the apartment is to use the things that I have as decoration. So everywhere I turn, I'm going to look at something that I enjoy looking at, whether it's my love for stationery, my journals, and my calendars and all that stuff, games, books, whatever it is that I like and enjoy looking at. That's what I'm going to decorate the house with. So every corner eventually will be set up to where whenever I look, I just feel very happy. Just realizing I'm not a minimalist, but I am going to minimize a lot.
Thank you for calling On TV Support. This call may be recorded or monitored for quality assurance.
Cette appel peut être enregistré ou surveillé à des fins d'assurance qualité. Esta llamada puede ser grabada o monitoreada para asegurar la calidad.
Thank you for calling customer service On TV. My name is Tina. May I know your name?
My name is Teresa.
Hey, Teresa. The number ending with 0141 is that your best callback number?
Yes, it is.
May I please know the model number to your TV?
100012.
Thank you for the information. How can I help you with the TV now?
This is my second TV, and I bought them both from Walmart, the same brand. But whenever I try to set up the new one with my email, it says that email's already being used. So I'm not sure how to set up the second TV. That lady did not help a bit. She gave me a number that all they had was where you can leave answering machines. So I just decided to try to figure it out myself. And I did.
Yeah. Where I act like I didn't know I was recording. I press the button. I walk away. I come back knowing the camera's on. All these... Listen, I'm probably the only real YouTuber left.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know what you want from me. I swear I don't.
I have three children.
I don't like it.
First thing you have to learn is...
I like the color. I don't like the dress.
Children are lying to you.
This is it. Her and it's sideways.
And if you don't
stop, I don't approve. Where did they go? I wanted to go with them dress shopping for the, I don't know, senior prom or something. I don't even know. I'm so out of touch with events that go on in high school in your last year. I woke up at 12:31. The reason why I woke up so late is because yesterday I woke up at 5, was out of the house at 6. I had to be somewhere at 6. Then I didn't go to bed till this morning, like 4-ish. So it was almost, I was almost up 24 hours. So I woke up at 12:31 and now it's 3:40. I'm sleepy again. And I already had coffee, but John, I can't afford to go to sleep. I'm gonna click off here and watch this show. I don't know what I'm watching. Nothing for real. Go find me something to watch. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you on the next video. Take care.